Welcome to Veranda IAS. In today's current affairs session in the subject Geography and Disaster Management, we will be dealing with the topic The Oldest Water on Earth. So the learning objective of today's LU is to discuss the oldest water on the earth and to examine the world's oldest water which is in use, to analyze the findings of the water and to outline the importance of these findings. So the world's oldest water on the 2.7 billion year old Canadian Shield, the world's oldest water, which is 1.6 billion years old water, was discovered in the year 2009 at Kit Creek mine by the geologist Dr. Barbara Sherwood Lawler. So where is this Kit Creek? It is in Canada. So the world's oldest water, how old it is? 1.6 billion years old water was found in this creek. So the mass spectrometers at Oxford University in the UK were used to determine the age of this highly saline water, which was 10 times saltier than the seawater. So the water which was found in this creek, it was saltier than the seawater we have today, 10 times highly saline water, which is more saltier than the seawater we have today. Further, water was discovered at the depth of 2.4 kilometers in Canada's Kit Creek mine. So usually the earth surface, it has an groundwater. So, but this water was found in a creek which is 2.4 kilometer deep. It is very much deep. So that is why these findings is very much significant. So this water was actually discovered in 2009, but its research report was recently published. That's why it is in news as of now. So further, the world's oldest water, why it is in news? In April 2021, the results of the oldest water on earth, according to the scientists, could reveal the knowledge about the nature of water and life on earth, as well as the prospect of finding lives on Mars. So we all know that the man has been searching for other living beings outside the earth, the water, the air, any other things which can support the human lives in areas which is outside the earth. We have been chasing these as for a longer period of time. So in our solar system, we have a zone called as Goldilocks zone. So what is this Goldilocks zone? So in any family, in any family of any star which is not so heat, that is which is not so much closer to the sun, the closest to the star of that particular family, and nor too far away. So the center point which has an medium heat and a medium cold temperature, that is the distance in between these two points, such a zone is called as Goldilocks zone. So usually in this zone, in our solar family, we have two planets. One is Earth and another is Mars. So Earth and Mars, they are actually present in these Goldilocks zone. So the scientists believe that the living beings would have been existed in Mars billions of years ago. So if we found such a living beings in Mars, and we should find what had destroyed them, what took the life on Mars, so it would be useful for the humans. So these findings are very much important, because if we can find water on the sheets of Earth in 2.4 kilometer deep, the scientists hope that we can find the same thing or the traces of water also in the surface of Mars. So that is why this report has been very much significant with respect to the scientific inventions regarding to this creek, which is regarding to this oldest water which is present in the creek. So moving on further, let's see what are the findings of this water. So the water was 10 times saltier than the seawater when it was discovered. So in this highly saline water, chemolithotrophic microorganisms have managed to live. These bacteria that can survive in the most hostile conditions, such as in the absence of light, in the presence of organic matter, etc. So these microorganisms also eat nitrogen and sulfide. The chemistry that kept them alive is comparable to that found in the ocean sediments, which have been known to maintain similar extreme life forms. So what that it means, the water, it had microorganisms in them. So which means, if microorganisms can sustain in 2.4 kilometers deep water, which is 1.4 billion years old, then the same can happen in the surface of the Mars also. These bacteria, they actually eat nitrogen and sulfide. So we can have a hope that these kind of organisms, similar organisms, can also be found in any other planet, such as Mars or even in Moon, we can say. So further, this report also says that these organisms has a chemistry that was comparable to that found in ocean sediments. So which means that this part, this creek, Kit Creek, which was found, was once an ocean. So that is why we see that we have these ocean sediments in these bacteria. So once it was an ocean, but in a matter of time, with the shifting of poles, we see that the oceans dried up, the deserts, the ocean became the deserts in the evolution of Earth. So this thing had actually happened. So Kit Creek was once an ocean. So because of that only, the salt water was found in this creek at 2.4 kilometers deep. So further, we also want to note that ocean water at that time was saltier than what we have now. Okay. Further, the findings of water, as a result, it was determined that the Canadian Shield, on which the Kit Creek mine is located, once served as an ocean bottom, as we discussed before. The horizontal seafloor turned vertical due to millions of years of flux from which the water sample was actually collected. Further, let's find out what are the importance of these findings. So the Canadian Shield, with the least tectonic activity, is the Earth's closest approximation to the Mars surface. So this creek has a better, more similarity when compared to the Mars surface. So hence, as we discussed before, we can have a very good hope that we can find a water or any other things which can sustain life, or even we can find organisms which can be living all these years in the Mars subsurface. If there is life-sustaining water beneath the Canadian Shield, which is 2.0 kilometers below the subsurface of the Earth, then again, in case of Mars, it is likely that the same may be said. Further, as a result, this hypothesis aids Mars missions like Perseverance. The Perseverance and other missions are searching for indication of life on Mars, both current and in past. So Perseverance is a mission of NASA. Recently, it has discovered is a great number of things which was not known for humans all these days. The Ingenuity mission is a part of an Perseverance mission. It was an helicopter model which was actually traveled in the surface of Mars. So this Perseverance has actually landed in the creek in Mars. So again, these things coincides with the what we have actually latestly found with regard to the Kit Creek. So these findings can actually give, if the Perseverance mission was successful in finding life, it will be a great achievement for the human space missions. So that's all. To summarize this LU, we have seen the oldest water on Earth, the world's oldest water which is in news, and the findings of the water and the importance of these findings. So that's all for today's LU, and have a nice day. Thank you.